Welcome back. It's still Daybreak Africa, and we're being joined in the studio right now by a leadership consultant, very young, Dr. Chris Udofia, who will be discussing leadership problem in Nigeria or challenges with leadership in Nigeria. Thank you indeed for coming.
Thank you very much.
I'm very delighted because when you talk of leadership, it's somewhat been defined in Nigeria to mean that you have to see somebody who is elderly and all of that. By the way, the leaders we have today, almost on all fronts, started very young.
Sure.
And there has been promise of taking leadership for to the young people, and we're still waiting. And the young bill, I'll call it the young bill, was signed into law. Let's just go into business for the day. Quickly, I want you to not just define leadership, but situate it to Nigerian affairs now.
Thank you very much. Leadership has been a major challenge world over, not just Nigeria, but let's focus on home.
Absolutely. Nigeria. Charity begins at home.
Sure. If we're looking at leadership, one word for leadership is influence. Mm. And the ability to influence your sphere, your space, your world. If you don't have that, your leading will be corrupt. That's where we have corruption spread all over. Because usually I came up with a word that I said, if the person of the leader is corrupt, his office will not be innocent.
Interesting.
Because it is not just about the office, it's about the person. So leadership begins with me, not with leading people. Leading people is not leadership, and that's where we get it all wrong. So that must be redefined. That must be, we need to come back to the table and redefine that. It's not, you even if you don't have anybody following you, you're still a leader.
Interesting.
Yes, sir.
Because you lead your life.
You lead yourself. So if you can't lead you can't lead me. So how are you able to lead yourself would determine how successful you can lead me.
Okay, before we narrow it to how perhaps, like many have said, or perhaps result we see shows that there has been mishaps with leadership in Nigeria, does it mean that not just those who have emerged as leaders, but the Nigerian has a challenge with leading his life? Do you agree with that analysis?
Leading his life?
Yes.
Yes, because we all have it all wrong. The individual does not even understand himself. And as long as you don't have an understanding of who you are, you can't have an understanding of me. Jim Rohn said, take care of you for me, and I will take care of me for you.
Interesting.
It's not the other way around. Don't try to take care of me for yourself. Take care of yourself for me, and I will take care of me for you.
So in other words, I work on myself.
You work on yourself.
Because I am looking at you.
Yes.
Perhaps to, even if it's not to lead you literally,
sure,
to give you a direction, sure, even from a distance, going by the way I
lead
my life.
That's where influence comes in, because you influence people without you even knowing.
Interesting.
Yes, influence is not something, you are influencing people positively or negatively without you knowing. So that's why you must be careful of how you live your life, because somebody is either being inspired by the way you live or expiring.
Interesting.
By the way you live.
With a lot of people watching, this is Monday morning, and a lot of offices are opened. We always mistake it for until I become a political figure, then I'm a leader. But of course, from what I've understood, leadership is everywhere.
Leadership is everywhere.
And so in your office, wherever you are, you're a leader. And so on a Monday morning like this, we're discussing leadership. And for me, it's a call. It's a wake-up call for all of us to look at ourselves and perhaps begin to do soul searching.
Yeah.
And in that light, would you say that the way leadership has emerged in Nigeria, do they have the right mindset that primarily is for them to solve problems? Do they understand that?
I won't say they do, because I wouldn't want to be judgmental here.
Okay.
But if you look at it critically, most people think they want to solve problems. They think they want to solve problems.
Assumption?
Yes, it's an assumption. They are not solving problems. They are just there to serve their self-interest. Look at it critically. We're not here to discuss people as in personalities.
Exactly.
You understand? But if you look at it in depth, majorly, people are not there because they want to solve problems. Even though when they run for office, that's what they tell us. And we just buy into all what they tell us. Check their manifestos and see at the end of day, are they able? Their manifestos does not even depict what they stand for. They are two different things.
That's a very sad one to hear.
They are two different
things. It sounds realistic.
They are two different
things. That's what I was doing. So we've got election going on in Bayelsa and Kogi. So all of these hula baloo, it's not about people emerging to solve problems.
They are not. They are not trying to. Even if they want to solve, okay, they want to solve. They will come tell you we're going to fix the roads for you. Okay, there's this road I walk past every other time, and they've treated that road twice this year.
In 2019.
They've treated that road twice. And I was just driving past yesterday and they said roadblock. I said, what's happening here? They said they are fixing the road again for the third time.
They need another opportunity to fix it, perhaps.
So what are they fixing? What problem are they fixing? They are not fixing problems because they don't even know what the problem is.
Okay, now, taking people into leadership now, given the way leadership emerged in Nigeria,
yes, sir.
Do these people who believe they can lead people even understand what it takes to take people into leadership?
When you don't know what leadership is, you can't know what to do when you get there. All you just need to do is, when you get there, because you don't understand what leadership is in the first place, so when you get there, you don't even know what to do, so you just play along.
So, for instance, I'm not bringing anything to the table.
They are not bringing anything.
I just asked, how is it done? Not necessarily how it should be done.
It should be done. And in leadership, the place of value is critical.
Ethics.
Most of our leaders don't even have the right values for leadership. Even though I don't promote qualities of leadership, because it's you are not a leader because you have qualities for leadership. That's not what makes you a leader.
Well, many think so.
Many think so. That's why they need to be orientated. They need to come back and have a better understanding of what leadership is all about. Mm. A new orientation is needed at a time like this. For us to move forward as a nation, we need to understand it. For us to forge ahead, for us to move to the next level, we need to understand this. A new orientation. And that's why we're trying to come up with a new tribe of leadership. That's what we're working on.
Okay, that's a project you're putting together.
Yes, sir.
We've got over 100 or perhaps 200 million Nigerians. The figures keep going back and forth. Oh, 210, oh, 201 and all of that. But we have at least roughly 200 million Nigerians.
Let's just say 200.
200 million.
Okay.
Is it a tall order to take all of these millions of people along to a place where they begin to see leadership as a place to serve?
It's very possible, because if you will permit me, we read in the Holy Book that Moses led 3 million people.
Mm.
You understand? And if from that scenario, an individual could lead such large crowd, and he did it successfully.
In one swoop.
In one. And he was successful at what he did. We can also do it. It's just for us to learn the principles. We're not getting it right from the principles. Mm. The principles of leadership must be understood. The spirit of leadership must be understood. And we are talking of excellence in leadership.
Okay, we just have 1 more minute to go. I knew from the outset that is a subject that we cannot even scratch.
Obviously.
With the time allotted to us. But can you just, in 30 seconds, just pinpoint some of these pointers to leadership?
All right. Leadership is all about the individual understanding his giftings first and foremost. And you bring your giftings into play, that is where to serve with, because most people understand that leadership is all about service. Yes, It's all about service. So what are you serving? Your gifts. You're serving with your gifts. So understand what your gift is and bring it to play. That's your trademark in leadership. And of course, you must have the spirit of excellence in leadership. If you don't have it, you can't lead right.
Wow. Just to mention some names, it's been said many times that a few Nigerians, and I want to mention one, someone like Fela Durotoye and so on, who in the 21st century perhaps has that quality or some of those qualities displayed on the outside, not tested yet, but at least perhaps could have done something, is still finding his way there.
Yeah.
We just may perhaps some other time we'll discuss on how some of these people with these qualities that we see will be given the opportunity to get there and see if they'll be able to put that to work. Thank you indeed for coming.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Chris Udofia is a leadership consultant. Out of your tight schedule, you found time to be with us today at this time. We appreciate that a lot and hope to see you some other time.
Sure. I'm available for service.
This very important subject.
Yeah.
Because, of course, if we don't get it right, perhaps we'll still be a distant away, the promised land.
Sure.
That is. We appreciate you.
Thank you very much.
All right. This is where we will be going for another break after this interview with a leadership consultant here on Daybreak Africa. We'll come back and bring you the rest of the program. Please stay with us.